Hey everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play The Binding of Isaac. First thing I want to say is, I just have a quick question. How many of you, are actually interested in the Let's Play continuing? Because, I mean, I think it should continue, but if you guys don't really care about seeing it, I can just do challenge runs all the time or something. But I don't know. It's really your guys' preference that matters. I'm just providing the content. You guys are the ones that want to watch it. And if this isn't what you want to watch, well, why should I do it? So, I mean, that I'd appreciate comments and stuff. But beyond that, I'm playing Kane today. And, yeah, that's about that. Remember to leave your custom challenge run suggestions in the comments. I hate when you spawn next to a room that takes a key and it just uses the key automatically. That's stupid, and, you know, of course I can't afford anything because, yeah, I start with 0 cents and one key, and now my one key is absolutely wasted because there's no way I'd ever want to use it right away on the shop on the first floor. Anyway, Kane has Lucky Foot. Lucky Foot means no pills are bad, and he has a higher win rate on all arcade machines, as well as more drops, I believe. So anyway, let's do that. Range up, that's good, because Kane starts with pretty low range, so definitely satisfied with range up. Would have preferred tears up, I'd say, but, you know, I'm not going to complain too much. And Spelunker's hat is also very good. What that does is, when you're next to a secret room, it shows you that you're next to a secret room, and it also shows you if you're next to a mini-boss room. So, like, there you can see that that's the top secret room and that's the secret room, but I don't have any bombs, so it doesn't really matter. Anyway, that'll save us a lot of bombs in the total of the run, which is good. Assuming I get, you know, any bombs in order to make use of it well. Of course, I won't on this floor. And unfortunately, next floor I won't start with any bomb or any keys because my only key was wasted by the start of the game, which really kind of sucks. And it's not just really kind of sucks; it really sucks. Anyway, another thing, you guys should feel free and leave games you might want to see me play on the channel. You know, Xbox and PS3 recordings are way better now than they were. Not that they were bad before. Let's use this pill. Bad gas. Okay. Two of clubs doubles our bombs. It'll also give us two bombs if we don't have any. Isaac's head is a little familiar. It'll follow us around. It shoots enemy piercing tears. Anyway, yeah. Games you guys might want to see. I'm going to look in here because it could be an eternal heart, which would be nice. I will win on this every time I play it, so I may as well play it three times. Or just, you know, profit a little. I'm going to use two of clubs, go to the secret room. So yeah, games you might want to see. A couple people have expressed interest in gaming with subscribers kind of thing, and I'm totally down for that in some games. Yeah, just, you know, let me know stuff. I'm going to buy a key in the shop. Actually, no, I'm going to buy a soul heart. Yep. And beyond that, back to Isaac. So I just ask you guys a bunch of things, so leave wordy and well-thought-out comments, preferably. But if not, I mean, concise comments, as long as they're answering the questions, are totally cool with me. My little unicorn, by the way, is going to allow us to become invincible and do contact damage to enemies. And, yeah, that's that. Recharges every 6 rooms, so it's a slow one, but what can you do? Good thing we got another soul heart there. Of course, it was silly of me to lose half, but whatever. I thought they might do that. And we got a bomb. Two bombs, of course. And let's see what's in the item room. Hopefully a better space. Oh god, we're having an Ipecac run. Alright, let's do this, guys. Ipecac means we shoot arcing poison bombs. So we no longer are going to want for bombs, ever. Gee, should we do it? No, we shouldn't. But we should touch it so that it doesn't spawn again. That's something I need to start incorporating into my gameplay. Anyway, Ipecac, yeah, we won't want for bombs anymore. But we are in a prime position to be damaging ourselves or having difficult times with rooms. Like, you see that? That it's hard to hit some enemies, especially the faster ones. Let's see what's in this Tinted Rock, another Soul Heart. That's good. Getting lucky with that, and we're going to need to continue getting lucky with that because I'm my own worst enemy right now. We can see that there's a mini boss right here, so I will take that second after. Oh god. This is one tough room. Oh, by the way, it doesn't matter if I destroy poop anymore because exploding poop doesn't count as shooting it, won't give any drops. Oh good, two soul hearts, one of the few times that a red chest is actually useful. I'm surprised we're having incredible luck. Super pride is not the worst thing that could happen. Especially when that happens. A dead cat, not at all interested, I'm gonna have to say. Like, not even once. There are advantages, but I don't want. Anyway, we'll go fight the boss and, you know, see what happens. So what I really want is homing shots. Homing shots would be great. And Gertie Jr. is going to go down surprisingly easily. And we get a health up and a deal with the devil, which means this could be great, in fact. Do we want to take the nail? Yeah, we want to take the nail. Let's take the nail. This is going to be kind of a fast and loose run, I guess. I mean, not that it's going to definitely be fast. Anyway, the nail is basically Book of Revelations, but objectively better, because it has the same effect where you can get a soul heart every 6 rooms, but it also makes you stronger and allows you to eat rocks and allows you to damage enemies by coming into contact with them. So yeah, it's good. Oh my god. See, spiders are not my friends in runs where I have Ipecac. Unless I have homing tears. If I have homing tears, it's totally fine. Well, not totally fine, but much more fine. Let's just fight the boss, because we don't have any keys anyway. The hollow should be super easy, especially because it's not a champion. So yeah, we get another soul heart. I don't know why we're having such incredible luck with that. We also get a health up, so, I mean, everything's going really, really well. Ipecac hasn't had the time to have a really terrible room yet. We haven't done that much damage to ourselves. Here we have top secret room, and yes, I did intentionally leave out the article the, so don't get on my case, any of you grammar Nazis. I will play this because I want more soul hearts, I want trinkets, I want whatever. Tarot cards are cool, and you know, I'm not too worried about the shop because I didn't have quite 15 cents, and I'm sure that, I mean, yeah, I'm probably missing out on the compass, but sucks to be me sometimes. The sun, best card in the game, I'd say. The sun gives you full health, shows the full map, and does significant damage to every enemy in the room. So, like, really, you just cannot get much better than what the sun is. It's like 4 of the cards in the game combined into one to be one super great awesome card. I can't get into the item room by any means. I really desperately need a key. Absolutely want to use the nail. I mean, you guys are dead. That's not a key. I really want a key. That was good. That's not a key either. So it looks like we are... Wait. Okay, yeah, I have gone to the secret room and the top secret room. I mean, I could do that, but it'd give me a golden chest, and that's not helpful. There's no way I can fly to this. Those are all trinkets in there, not actually tarot cards. So we're missing an item room, which is probably, alright, let's do something risky. We're looking for a teleport into the item room. I guess I'll take Guppy's tail, even though that's kind of a disadvantage. Okay, so we got some pills. Speed up, that's good. Bad gas, not as good as the sun. Anyway, Guppy's tail increases his spawn rate of golden chests, but decreases his spawn rate of other things. So, I mean, it's kind of bad, but I'm not... whatever. Like I said, fast and loose. I'm gonna blow this up. Cain's eye, which is funny, as Cain, of course. Ace of Spades increases the drop rate of tarot cards and playing cards. Which, I mean, that's cool and all, but whatever. Good. Not good. Good. And we have a key, so we will be able to go to the item room on this floor. We'll be able to go to the shop as well, because we have enough money, provided we get the keys for such an outing. Alright, calm down. I probably should have taken another trinket other than Isaac's head, because it's not, like, horribly useful considering Ipecac. God, I feel like this exact thing happened in like Alpaca Patrol's Let's Play, where he had a we're gonna have to bomb this so I don't have to use a key. Anyway, he had Isaac's head and Ipecac, and like he went from a room like this to a room like this. It was crazy, man. Oh yeah, I'll just take the Eternal Heart. If I'm losing the Eternal Heart with all these soul hearts, I have bigger problems. Anyway, yeah, check out Alpaca Patrol if you haven't, you know, if you don't already watch him. I very much enjoy him. I was trying to get him to do a dual com, but I'm not very well known, so, you know, if you guys all want to spam him with links to me and how he should do dual coms with me, don't actually do that. That's rude and annoying, I'm sure. But, you know, I was... Jeez, I should use a nail by now. Yeah, I was trying to get that to happen, but he didn't really respond to that. No big deal. You know, I'm going to stick with Isaac's head over Liberty Cap, even though I was, like, just saying how... Yeah, you know, I should change these things. And then, yep, oh well. Okay, so we're going to go to the shop because we now have enough keys. We're going to look for the item room because we want to go to the item room where it's going to contain homing shots, hopefully. Compass? Greed. Well, you're a jerk, game. Alright, you're dead. Of course you dropped a golden chest. Got a bunch of money now. That's chill. Not a big deal. Mary Jr., yeah, dies in one hit. Got another key. I'm not going to use it to open any of the golden chests unless I suddenly come into money and stuff. Not money, like, in the literal sense, but money in the form of keys. This room wasn't too bad. Let's see what's in here. Compass, I'm doing it. See, that's, like, exactly what I was going to say. I was going to say, if it's a compass, yeah, I'll do it. That was terrible, terrible damage. So yeah, you know, exactly the result I wanted. Which means, why would I ever not do it? Compass is pretty much one of the most valuable items in the game. Compass, of course, will show us the location of all of the icon rooms. As you can see by the floating item room thing there. Tinted rock, that's good. Oh, better use a nail. I'm not really worried about it for the damage as much, but the damage does help, I'm sure. Yeah, so the compass will help us shorten our escapades on later floors, like the womb, where we don't want to visit every room, we just don't want to go straight to the boss. And here it just helps us go, oh, little Gish, that's another familiar that'll follow us around. It'll shoot slowing tears, which are my favorite kind of tears. Yeah, the compass will speed us up, and it'll help us search for the item room earlier, which is always what I want, because, you know, up! That was pretty much what I was talking about, so I'm totally seeing Django Unchained, finally. I wanted to see it on Christmas Day, but no one was up for that. Really what I wanted. But anyway, I'm finally going to get to see that, I guess, today for you guys, so I'm excited. I am a Tarantino fan. But, you know, some people probably don't share that opinion. That's fine, you know. I think he makes some good movies. At least entertaining movies, for me. You know, some people might not like the super violence and all the language and stuff. That's cool, you know. Some stuff is not for everyone. I don't watch rom-coms, really. Same kind of deal. Alright, so we got the coin purse. That is good, because we're Picane. So, tears up. Predicted. Range up. This might be terrible to take both of these range ups, but tears up, you know, that's cool. Take the sun card, just in case it's Krampus in there. Krampus would be great, actually. It is not Krampus. Do I want to do this for the extra damage? Yeah, let's get crazy. That's two damage up, one speed up, I think, and it's also one soul heart, so, you know. We'll get a health up as we enter the next floor here. And, kind of, I'm trying to set myself up. I heard the jingle, so I know that there's a secret room. Dad's key is fine, but I don't really want to go for it. I don't want to take... Oh, okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back in there. We're going to touch it. And I'm going to take the nail back. I'm getting used to it. I'm learning to do this. Yeah, so... You know, sorry if, our music... Or, not music. Well, music tastes may not, overlap either. But sorry if our taste in movies does not overlap. I'm excited. Don't want to do that by accident. Of course, Curse of Darkness negates our compass effect. That was a terrible, terrible dodge into that fire. So, you know, we're just going to pretend it didn't happen. Let's hope there's something good in here. Whatever, more money. I want to use that. We got another tinted rock where maybe we'll get the small rock. We did not. We got another bomb and soul heart. Soul hearts are always good. Anyway, the sun's mostly going to be useful for not full health, because if we're down to a point where we need full health from it, we're probably going to die. It's mostly going to be for either a map or for the damage. Probably more the damage than the map. Oh, I didn't think that would happen. So no one shoots at me again. Excellent. We got another key. Also excellent. See if it's here. No, it's here. We heard the jingle for the secret room, of course. The top secret room. And then we get another eternal heart. That'll be another health up, hopefully. Yeah, we want to touch the D20. But I don't think I've left anything laying around, really, that I want to reroll. Of course, I could reroll a chest that's up here or up here, but I'm probably just not going to do that, you know? Oh, these rooms suck when you have explosive items like Ipecac, because flies are pretty much impossible to deal with. There, we got another key. Keys are excellent. Don't see enough of them, I'd say. Oh, the one time... You had one job, Ipecac. Oh god. Apparently leapers are my worst nightmare. Good thing I can fire frequently thanks to those tears ups. Oh, I thought I was gonna hit myself again. Oh, that was so bad. Yeah, again, leapers, worst nightmare. Clearly. Hey, just die. Okay, so I took like two or three hits there. That's kinda not fun. I want to go to the shop, that's for sure. It's probably going to have super greed this time. But, you know, in the event it doesn't, maybe we pick up a treasure map. Maybe we pick up, I don't know, the blue candle. Anything. Okay, nothing in there that I want. Shop. I guess I missed the shop somewhere. Maybe I'd... Oh, man. Have I gone up yet? I don't think I have. But that wasn't my... Oh, I want to use that. Just in time, I'd say... Oh, God. Stop it. Stop it. Good thing none of these fires are malicious. He just took damage and didn't die. How is that even possible? Oh, God. Okay. We have found our objective. And guts are easy with Ipecac, at least. Okay, so we're going to get a soul heart and a key. And not the notched axe. And not the tarot card, because I have the best tarot card. Yep. And, of course, I don't have enough keys to justify those golden chests. I don't know why I took the tail. Probably in hopes of becoming Guppy, which would be awesome, but also not awesome. I mean, it would be awesome. Anyway, we're fighting Gish, which is interesting, by the way. Since we already have Little Gish, instead of dropping Little Gish, Gish will just give us a normal boss drop. Which is fine, because, you know, normal boss drops are good. Some of them. Pageant Boy excluded from that. But this should be easy. Because, I mean, Ipecac does a bunch of damage. He spawned an eye blob. I didn't know he could do that. Yeah, so everyone... Okay, he died from the poison. Got another soul heart. Got a health up and damage up, even though it says tears up. And we go down the next floor, get another health up from the Eternal Heart. We are just doing really well with Kane this run. I'm going to go down first, even though I think that the, oh god. I think that the item room's going to be off the, upward path. Okay, let's kill something. There we go. So yeah, I don't think it's going to be the downward path, but I'm doing it anyway. Sometimes you got to learn not to trust your instincts. Anyway, how are everyone's holidays, if they're, provided they're over? I don't know. Dates for all the holidays, but yeah, how'd they go for everyone? I hope they were great. I did pretty well. Not really gonna go into that too much, but good times. Oh, gonna take damage here. Most likely. Unless we're super lucky, which we might be. Which we are. Alright, so we got a nail charge. Gotta remember, make sure to use that. And we found the shop, at least. There's no mini-boss room here, so I should use the nail there. So yeah, that's what I was saying. Probably got greed. We got greed, so last shop, worthless. Maybe we'll find a beggar somewhere. And like I was saying, the item room was probably off the upward path. Of course, I didn't use the nail then either. I gotta get on top of my game here. You know, I'm gonna come from all the way over here. Just finish the whole nail. I'm getting there. Nail, definitely a good item. You fools, stay away from me. Going down here. Okay, these guys didn't make the chain reaction that I wanted from them. But they should be easy enough to handle, and they are. Let's see if there's anything in here. Treasure map, speedball, whatever. Of course, I haven't found speedball on this file, which is why I said that. And that's like the only place that speedball can spawn in, well, no, I guess it can spawn in item rooms, I think. But I think that the most common place is challengers. Oh, no, stop it, big spider. Which is his legitimate name, not just what I'm calling him. Whatever. I should go to the arcade. In fact, I will go to the arcade just in case it's a fortune teller machine. If it's a fortune teller machine, I must play that with all of my might, all of my monies, because I'm guaranteed to win. Like, I think you have like a 99% chance of winning as Kane, which is probably a bug, but it's cool with me. I'm not complaining. Okay, it is not. But I should play this twice. I didn't mean to do that, but I have a 50% chance to win on this. I didn't win. But really, I don't want to take the time to get Skatol, even though I should. Just, I don't want to. Gambling takes too much time in this game. In the remake, it should take less time. That's one of the things that Ed McMillan said. So I'm going to play the beggar before I go to the top secret room, because I don't want to blow him up by accident. But yeah, Edmund McMillan said the remake would have faster gambling, which, excellent, it means I'll probably gamble more. Oh, that was bad. Alright, so we're just going to take this, and this is actually faster gambling, by the way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shoot for, well, I guess speed up is not desirable. I'm going to shoot for pretty flies. Okay, so that's open. Yeah, coins not too valuable, but we're going for pretty fly. I really didn't want this item, though. Portable slots, of course, is just a portable slot machine, basically, except it can't give you the dollar or anything like that. It can give you a bunch of other drops. Pills being one of the most frequent. What's this pill? Range up. Yeah, sure, why not? Although that's probably making it harder for me to use Ipecac efficiently. Let's see what this is. Health up. That's excellent, in fact. So, I mean, this is worth it right now. Yeah, I wasted that. I should have gone and played the blood bank. It's too far away, man. Too far away. I just want pretty flies. But if not, I mean, that's fine. I want to use all my money. Maybe get more health up pills, because pills, again, are a common drop. And this run's going pretty quickly, I'd say, thanks to Ipecac. Maybe I'm wrong, though. Can we... We're just going to ignore him because he's harmless. If this were, Oh, there we go. Pretty fly. Pretty fly can kill fly-type enemies. By the way, we can use portable slot machine to re-roll boss fights, like just to fight a boss again, if we really want to. Bad gas. Can kill you with that. By just, as long as we can get out of the boss room, if we play it enough to get one of those black flies that's an enemy to spawn, then we get, and we leave the room, it counts as being unexplored, and then we get to fight the boss again. Cool stuff. This floor and the next floor are really the only times that's ever valuable, but... Well, I mean, any floor before Womb 1, it's valuable. Except really this one, because you have to be able to teleport out consistently, which I wouldn't really count on. But, hey, cool stuff if you want to do kind of... It's kind of like the Nine Lives exploit, except without dying a lot. Which, in my eyes, makes it much better. But you also have to have enough money to make that worthwhile. And enough luck on getting those black flies. Anyway, we've gotten two pretty flies, which, again, that's why I'm playing this. I want a third one to have a full orbital ring of protection, blocking enemy tiers, and also damaging at least fly-type enemies. Of course, if I had, like, Guardian Angel, Sacrificial Dagger, or Cube of Meat, any of those three, those damage all types of enemies. The last pill probably range up again, so one of them is ranged down. We're almost done here. I really want that last pretty fly. Like, I really, really want it. We're profiting again. Stop that. Stop that. Stop giving me money. I don't need bombs either because I have infinite bombs coming out of my mouth. I'm throwing up bombs, okay? Just calm down, Binding of Isaac. Alright, we're almost there. And then, oh god. It just wants us to keep playing forever. Plenty of hearts. I guess I'll go play the blood bank. That's range up, isn't it? Yes, it is. Okay, we done? We done? Of course we're gonna... Oh my god, I'm so bad sometimes. We're gonna come back and have to play it a bunch more times because we're gonna have a bunch more coins. And, you know, that's okay. I want those pretty flies. That pretty fly, really. Anyway, we'll play down to half a heart and probably not take the time to come all the way back once we get back to full health. By the way, if this gives us a blood bag, we'll get back to full health anyway. And we'll just have whatever money profit we made. Alright, done here. We also have the sun, which could be used just for full health, but I think that's kind of a waste. So we're just not going to do that. Crazy, I know. Okay, three hearts. I guess it would be worth it, but first let's see if we get our last pretty fly. If we do get our last pretty fly, then I'm not going back, but if we don't, then I'll go back to try some more. Man, this floor is taking a long time. We haven't even gone to the item room, which I know is like one room off of the next room. Oh well. Anyway, with more than 3.5 hearts, we'll certainly, it'll be worth it to go play the blood bank a bunch, but I don't want to have to. Health, no, that's bad gas. Okay, never mind. I was excited for a second. That's the, no, that's tears up. It's also good. I think that will allow us to shoot Ipecac faster, but if not, nah, whatever, it's harmless. Stop it with the money. I just want a pretty fly. You gave me two already. Maybe I'll take the speed up so that I can get back and forth faster. Yeah, let's go. I'm just hanging on to this because why not? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play it in the arcade to save the time backtracking, knowing that I have enough hearts to get back to full way back there if I don't get enough hearts over here. Crazy, I know. Truly a visionary. Alright, so we got the blood bag. So then I'm going to go way back there. And then this can finally be over. Blood bag is a speed up one and health up one, as well as 4 hearts of recovery. So we're super fast, and I don't like it. Never really like being particularly faster than one speed upgrade for any given character. Like, that's generally the sweet spot, pretty much. Oh, please, just give me the fly. That's all I want. I played this, like, 70 times. Alright, fine. But I'll come back for you. Oh, no. By the way, that didn't hit me because the flies saved me. They do that when things are charging at you. They're just like, nah, man, we got this. And you're like, cool. Of course, that time it didn't work out because it went between the flies. The flies, of course, only kill fly-type enemies, and guess what? Spiders aren't fly-type enemies. So this room is actually butts, and I'm just going to bomb my way out. Pro maneuvering, but I still got hit a bunch of times, so not like, oh god. Alright, that's that room. Got our nail charge for the mom boss fight, that's cool. Ah, good. We've got blue mom, which spawns Wrath of the Lamb enemies, which makes it harder. But, Ipecac, as long as we're shooting it well, is going to be able to kill all of the enemies relatively quickly, so we don't have to worry too much about them. And also does poison damage, which is good times. And that's going to be that boss fight. Squeezy is an excellent item. It gives us 2 soul hearts as well as tears up. We get the Polaroid. Really, we've had incredible soul heart luck. I really want to reiterate that a little bit. Oh, I didn't touch the heart. I'm sorry, guys. I've let you down. I'm a monster. This room's gonna be annoying. Never mind, we finally got him. Do need to make sure to destroy every rock in the room that I come across, because You can't tell tinted rocks from the other rocks, so you got to destroy all of them if you have the means. If you want to find any tinted rocks, of course. So, and you know, it's a total luck of the draw kind of deal, because maybe you don't come across them. Maybe they're in the rooms you don't explore, maybe they're just not there in general. That's handled. He doesn't count as a champion down here, apparently. Chariot allows us a one-time use of the My Little Unicorn, which I think I had earlier. I must have had it earlier, because I have the feeling that I've had it, and I've only done one run today. Problem solved, guys. Oh, you spawned on me. But see, again, people who complain about that, I think are, their complaints are unfounded. Oh, that was close. I'm gonna play this twice, because I'm gonna win. Anyway, their complaints are unfounded because they are intangible, they can't do contact damage to you. For a few seconds, I would love to take the tick, but I wouldn't be able to get the Polaroid back if I did. And, of course, I want to go to the chest, yo. We did not find the boss room, unfortunately. But here we go, got the nail charged. So yeah, if I had Mom's purse, I'd happily pick up the tick, because the tick is a very good, I didn't destroy the rocks. Come on, what am I doing? MLG Rock Destroyer, you know? Sorry if it's time consuming, I just want all the soul hearts I can get, man. None in here, none in here, okay. Also the nail, that'll allow me to destroy the rocks with a great ease. I would love to go to that golden chest, but I haven't been going to others, and this one's more dangerous than the others. Let's go down. Well, oh, well, there's our tinted rock there. I've never seen more than one tinted rock in a room, because I'm pretty sure it's impossible. So, yeah, nail. I got you guys. Chubb has three sections, and they all take damage individually, so, well-placed Ipecac shots are way, way better against Chubb, as is anything, that can hit multiple sections of things at once. So, you know, that's just... Oh, that was so bad. Okay. Oh, I thought I was going to take more damage there. Really, truly, not the best room for a high-range Ipecac, I must say. Let's see what this card is. Oh, the Fool... That'd be Zero the Fool, so it wasn't clear. That, of course, would take us to the spawn room. Which, not... Oh, come back, please. Thank you. Not particularly valuable. Let's see what this is. Here, Fawn, that's amazing. That gives us two soul hearts. And that's not going to be the secret room. This is going to be the secret room. Actually, I don't know why. I'm wrong. Either of them could have been the secret room. I will play this once, absolutely, because we could get a soul heart. No, the matchstick, not the most valuable thing for me. How did you live? What? Man, these guys have a lot of health. Oh no. Oh, that was a good shot. Like, again, MLG sniper right here. Whoa. Do you guys see that? Like, do you realize what happened? I was moving backwards with such velocity or something, or like I hit the wall. And when I shot, the shot I shot forward went backward. It was crazy, man. So this, I figure, is going to save us some time if we bomb our way through it. I guess I'll play this again since I picked up a scent that I didn't even notice. Oh, good, we got a soul heart. So, yeah, that's exactly what I was hoping to happen. We found our boss room, and this is only room one still. Wow, this has been a long floor because I've had to explore pretty much everything. So, yeah, destroy these rocks, have a party... Kill the boss. Simple, we kill the boss man. Oh, of course it's Conquest. Conquest is the worst. I hate Conquest. Conquest, pretty much the hardest boss. Well, one of the hardest bosses in the game. Without a doubt. Anyway, that was a tinted rock, so we don't have to worry about the other rocks in this room, but I might like to, just, you know, because they're kind of impeding upon my ability to be awesome. Anyway, I'm going to pick this up, and yeah, risk danger. Stop charging, you butt face. So I'm like hemorrhaging soul hearts right now, but it's a good thing I've been building them so well, like so luckily, all game. Oh no, we escaped that time. Okay, you'll die. Touch the white pony even though there's no reason to. We've got a nail charge. Save that for the next floor. Really sucks how much damage we took there, but whatever. So I'm hoping that right is the right way. Who knows? Perfect. Perfect shot, which is just what I wanted. You know, that's what you want Ipecac to do. Of course, I failed to use the nail. Let's do that this time. No, I thought I was going to take damage there. I was, like, almost certain of it. Oh. You guys, one of you's dead. All y'alls. This is one of the easiest rooms in the womb. Like, no, it's the easiest room with enemies in the womb. There's, like, literally no way you can do badly on it. What is this pill? Tears up. Sure, why not? Take the sun. This should be... Well, no, this can't not be the way to the boss. I don't know why the Doppel didn't die there. That was actually amazing. I'm impressed with the Doppel. I don't want to accidentally use a key here. Oh, no. Oh, that was so bad. Well, Doppel's dead, so that's one concern gone. All right, you're gone. We got 1+1 free. We got the Mom's Heart fight. This shouldn't be too bad. Ipecac, things is nice. Okay, good. We got that done. So now we sit here, and most enemies will just die by virtue of being hit by Ipecac. So we don't really have to worry at all until bosses spawn. And in fact, we got Mom's Heart to constantly firing bombs before any bosses spawned. Which is good. Unfortunately, our health is down now to where we can see it. But let's continue. I've gotten like 12 texts. Don't worry, they're all from one person. I'm not popular. That's the top secret room where, I don't know, what will we find? Bunch of red hearts. That's cool, but we already have the sun, which I think might come into use here on this flizzor. Don't, just ignore that I said that. Might come to use on the Isaac boss fight, though. That's the message to take from that without the stupid way I said floor. Goat Hoof would give us speed up, but I have enough speed. Anyway, yeah, I expect that, I mean, Isaac shouldn't actually be too tough due to the nature of us not firing that many tears and instead firing, bombs that do poison damage, so, like, that's really good against Isaac. I'm gonna save the nail for the, no, I'm not. Nail's pretty much worthless for us. Oh, God, get away from me. Okay, that's good. Let's just toss that way over there. Toss that up in there. Toss that there. I'm a pro with Ipecac. Not actually, I don't get much practice, in fact. Okay, you're gonna die, and then you're dead. Excellent. God, we've gotten so much money. This run really has gone amazingly well from a luck standpoint in pickups and stuff. Not like necessarily from items, but you know, items have been good too. So I don't know, this Isaac fight could go well. I expected it might because, again, we're not firing that many tears. We have two flies orbiting around us. We're going to do constant poison damage. And bombs, of course. Being Ipecac. Oh my god, stop texting me. I told you I was going to record. You knew this was coming. Yeah, so Isaac's going to be super simple. Provided we can make it through the chest, Blue Baby will be the same. We got an Eternal Heart. That becomes a health up. That's amazing. So let's go into the chest. And we got enough keys, so that's good, to pick up items we don't really need at all. Toothpicks is going to be tears up, but I think it's just shot speed up. Scapular gives us a soul heart when we get down to half a red heart. I'll use the deck of cards once because maybe it's the world or something. The devil doubles our damage for a room. I'm going to stick with the nail. I don't want Shoop to whoop. And that is our chest experience. Why not fight greed? Because why not fight greed, man? Tons of money. Haven't had to use sun card yet, which, you know, that's good stuff. Okay, that was the wrong way. I'm gonna hope it's down. Well, I haven't had to fight yet. It's totally down, too. Oh, no. Alright, so I have to take damage to get through this room, which is why I think that's a really poorly designed room. It's stupid and it shouldn't be in the game. And... you know, in a less fortunate circumstance, that ends your run, legitimately. But yes, you know, rooms where you have to take damage to get past should not be in a game. There's difficult and there's unfair. That's pretty much the divider. Like, this game, for the most part, is difficult. Rooms where you have to take damage, or where there's a very low chance of not taking damage, those are unfair. Because there are just some situations for some rooms where you just, you're not getting out without taking damage. You can't do it. I want to use the nail. Professionally avoiding lust until that moment. So the thing about that, it did do damage because contact damage from the nail. I did explain when you touch enemies, you do a pretty fair amount of damage to them. Okay, thank you for dying. I think the shot speed really did do a big difference on my Ipecac. It's going further. It's stuff is just, yeah, getting a lot of drops here though. The miter, pretty much, it felt like we had the miter all game. Oh, we got a soul heart from that. That's incredible. The miter is an increased chance that any red heart drop becomes a soul heart drop. Good times. Oh my god, not lust again. I did get caught in the wall there because I'm super fast. That only happens on the right wall, by the way. Because the right wall is broken in every way, it seems. Because if you guys didn't know, now homing bombs also is the reason that the bombs are going towards Wrath there. Oh my god. You know what, we're just... okay, lust, yeah, they're both dead. I guess we'll touch Mr. Boom. Don't really need it. We're not going to get a nail charge for Blue Babby. Anyway, the right wall is broken, as I was saying. If you didn't know, when you have Dr. Fetus, which is just the fetus in a jar that allows you to shoot bombs as tears rather than nuclear missiles, if you fire it at any wall... Well, okay, if you fire it at the left, top, or bottom wall, it just sticks to the wall, just stays on it. But if you fire it at the right wall, it bounces off, which is really annoying. So I don't know where, like, what causes that in the game's code or whatever. Like, I don't know what causes it, but the right wall is broken, and I would not recommend it. And that's that point of learning. Oh, could have easily hit myself with a kick there. Stuff went well here for this run. I think we're going to win, almost without a doubt. Three Lokis should be pretty easy. So yeah, I'm celebrating my victory now, even though I shouldn't, of course. There's plenty of ways this could go badly and cause me to die. But I have very good items, very good luck. I have the sun, which is insurance, should I take egregious amounts of damage that I don't expect to take. Yeah. Okay, we got a pill. What is this? Health up. Health up is actually going to be useful if we need to use the sun, but useless otherwise. So let's go. Blue baby. Shoots more tears than Isaac. Also spawns flies for the whole of the fight. Not a big deal. Look how fast and stuff we're firing. This is going to go fine. I'm not even going to dodge. I'm just going to look at my health bar. In case I need to use the sun. Okay, we'll just use the sun. Get a soul heart drop. You saw it be a red heart there for a second, just if you were watching closely or if the recording was fast enough to catch that. Anyway, that's that run. We beat the chest as Kane. If only I could do that as Samson. So yeah, leave comments regarding the stuff I said at the beginning. That's actually stuff I want to know. Stuff that's important for you as viewers and for me as a content creator. You can't skip this ending. But, yeah, that's all for that. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time. Tomorrow, of course, custom challenge run. Leave suggestions in the comments. I totally said that. Yeah, thanks for watching. See you next time. Later, guys.